Hello, hello. Chris Davis here with another Pauper Daily event recording. As you can see, had the event up there for a moment. I'm just about to get started. Have made some changes to this deck. You may notice a few new additions. I've got Raise the Alarm in the main deck now to try and take advantage of the plus one effects. And I've got more effects that pump all my creatures. Notably, I'm playing Gem Palm Avenger. Basically, I wanted to find another way to pump my creatures that was also just an okay card overall. And so this thing just cycles for three, so it's going to draw me a card when I play it, which is useful. Additionally, I don't know, I wanted to find something that wasn't going to lose me card advantage. I considered Guardian's Pledge also, which would be pretty sweet, but I figured the extra utility available from Gem Palm Avenger probably makes it worth it. And in some combat situations, that first strike is sort of like another plus one, so it's useful for that reason as well. So I'm doing some new things with the deck as well. Have Deathblade Elite in here now. He's able to provoke guys and works really well with stuff like a Krozen Squire and Infantry Veteran. I took out all the artifacts, as you might be able to see. So even Bone Splitter is out of the deck now, because I didn't want to have too many pump effects and end up with not enough creatures. The deck needs a really critical mass of creatures to take advantage of these pump effects. So I figured Bone Splitter was a little bit of duplication with these effects, so trying it without Bone Splitter this time, we'll see if I regret that. But these cards are really good. And I mean, it took a lot of research to find Gem Palm Avenger for some reason. I just kind of forgotten about the card. But, you know, I did some soul searching, or in this case some soldier searching, and was able to find a good card to complement what the deck is trying to do. So that's what's going on with the deck this time. I'm also doing something I absolutely hate and playing only three core Skyfishers. Only three. I love this card so much, but it was leading to a lot of awkward draws. And I can't afford to have too many 2-drops when the deck is trying to be really quick and then just rally or gem palm them out. So playing with one less core Skyfisher, which hurts me a little bit, hurts my soul to do that, but it's probably the right decision. Squadron Hawk's still in the sideboard. I've maxed out on Journey to Nowheres now. Other than that, deck is very similar to what it was last week. And yeah, we'll hope that Deathblade Elite can do some work. It's certainly really good on the play. If you play a Deathblade Elite and they play a 1-1 and you play in a Krozen Squire, it's just absolutely absurd. Can be really good against the other aggressive decks, so gonna be trying that out. So that's what I got going on this time around. I will be back with round one very shortly. Again, very much appreciate you watching. I'll see you in just a moment.